food.
But how?
We have nothing. Just a few fish and some bread. Bring them to me.
So we're about halfway now between Christmas and Easter, and Hollywood is cranking out movies based on the Bible. The latest is called Son of God. It is the story of Jesus Christ based on the hit miniseries, The Bible, which did huge numbers for the History Channel. The producers got some high-profile Christian leaders involved in the production, and is being distributed by 20th Century Fox. Other religious figures getting Hollywood treatment include Noah, Moses, Cain and Abel, also starring in Hollywood, Pontius Pilate, and the Virgin Mary. So it seems like religious films are making a bit of a comeback in the land where some people think there isn't a whole lot of religion. So what's this all about? Joining me now, Father Jonathan Morris, a Catholic priest and Fox News contributor, and Joe Concha, a political and entertainment media columnist for Mediaite.com. Welcome to you both. Father Jonathan, let me start with you. Why do you think the big interest in these movies based on the Bible?
Sure, Martha. You know, I remember being on the set of the film The Passion of the Christ and being in a trailer on set with Mel Gibson and Steve McAvity, the producer, Jim Caviezel, the star, and Mel Gibson saying, you know what, if we don't make this successful, there will not be another religious, big, major Hollywood film for the next 50 years. Why? Because we've got all the star power, we've got the money that we're putting into it, and we've got lots of forces trying to stop this. And that's why he felt, and of course we know he had some major difficulties afterwards, but he felt very strongly a passion to get this done for the sake of the future of films. I think we're seeing some of that success playing out before us, as you mentioned, Martha.
Yeah, and because he felt so strongly about making that movie, he put a lot of his own money into it and made the movie fairly reasonably, as these things go, at $30 million. But the movie had a huge gross at the box office. Let's put up some of these numbers and get a look at how that turned out for Mel Gibson. The Passion of the Christ domestically brought in $370 million. You compare that to The Hangover at $207. So it turns out that these kind of themes can do very well at the box office. Joe, tell us about the money side of this. Why would Hollywood be so interested in these pictures?
Passion of the Prophet, Martha.
That kind of profit.
You mentioned $370 million before. If you include international receipts, Passion of the Christ made over $600 million.
Wow.
In the case of Son of God, that's based on a miniseries on the History Channel that averaged about 11.5 million people watching per night. Now, context
Mark
is everything.
Mark Burnett and Roma Downey are the couple behind this big movie,
yeah. What's 11.5 million? What does that really amount to? Well, Breaking Bad, which apparently everybody watched if you listen to the media, only 10 million watched that series finale. Yeah. So there is such an appetite for this, and I'll throw one more number out at you. 77% of Americans, this is according to Gallup, identify themselves as Christian in some way, Protestant or Catholic. That's well over 200 million people. So why not tap into that audience more? But if somebody isn't getting stabbed or shot, or there aren't 90 F-bombs being dropped, or if there isn't some sort of gratuitous sex scene, Hollywood doesn't think it'll sell. But history shows you make these movies, you do it right, you get actors like Russell Crowe or Christian Bale, who's going to do Exodus, it will make money. The audience is there. The appetite is there, Martha.
Christian Bale's a phenomenal actor.
I'd be
very interested to see how that goes. You know, Father Jonathan, you bring up your work as a consultant to the Passion of the Christ. And one of the reasons that you were there, of course, was to make sure that it was biblically correct, that it captured the spirit of the teachings of Jesus and the experience of the story of his life as told in the Bible. So one of the things that's controversial about Noah is that they're saying that he's being presented in a way that is, you know, really not what the Bible teaches. What do you think about that?
Yeah, no, that's a great point, Martha. And I think the recipe for success is not just, hey, it's religious, it's going to do well. No, it's got to be religious in terms of importance. And secondly, it's got to be respectful of the facts and respectful of people's faith. It's got to be inspiring, not just a rehashed story that is kind of decent. And then finally, it's got to be a stellar production. It's got to be quality. And what we saw in The Passion was unbelievably strong on all of those for most Christians, I would say, especially. Now, I just saw Son of God that you mentioned. I thought it was very respectful. I thought it was well done, worthwhile seeing. I don't think it's the production masterpiece that The Passion was, but a very good, and it's going to do very well, and I recommend it highly. Noah, I'm not so sure. There's a lot of controversy right now whether or not, you know, it's Russell Crowe is playing in it, whether or not they've done that inspiring and respectful piece. We'll see.
Yeah, we will see. Coming out in the theaters fairly soon. Father Jonathan, thank you very much. Always good to talk to you. Joe Marta, thank you.
Martha, thank you.